We have no way of knowing just what exactly was going on in the minds of the occultists of the Third Reich, and to what mysterious ends their ideas would lead them. Perhaps they believed in the ancient prophecy of the New Babylon, which would rise again in some unspecified centrally located country when the Third Sargon would return. The secret knowledge and the prophecies which the Knights Templar had brought back with them from the Orient had been slumbering for centuries, waiting for the time of fulfillment to approach. In 1919, von Zebottendorf joined with Karl Haushofer and Dietrich Eckart to form the Thule Society. This was to be a melting pot of various occult orders, with a network of connections throughout Germany. The center was to be in Munich. Many members of the Thule Society formed themselves in active opposition to the short-lived Socialist Republic of Bavaria. A political party was founded, and in 1921, Adolf Hitler, a man well known for his occult beliefs, was engaged as a political orator. Inspired by members of the Thule Society, Hitler's plan for a thousand-year Reich was born. The increasing political ambitions of the Thule Society resulted in a number of smaller groups going their own way. One of these groups was the Vril Society. Towards the end of 1919, a select group of people, members of both the Thule and Vril societies, met in an old hunting lodge near Berchtesgaden. Taking a prominent part in the proceedings for the first time was Dr. H.O. Schumann, a man whose area of expertise would today be called alternative energy. Nevertheless, the leading figure was the medium Maria Ortisch. A second medium was also present on this occasion. 18-year-old Zigrun. Maria Ortisch presented texts she had received from her spirit medium, one in the Sumerian alphabet and the other in the secret code of the Knights Templar. Both texts had already been translated. Were they messages from the gods? Or tidings from some alien civilization? Construction plans for the development of some new advanced technology which would enable mankind to reach for the stars? From now on, the members of the Vril Society devoted themselves wholeheartedly to the realization of what must be one of the most bizarre ideas that ever occurred to the mind of man. The construction of a time machine that would transport them to the realms of the beyond and bring them face to face with the gods themselves. We don't know just exactly how far they got with their machine. The experiments carried out lasted almost 2 years. What we can say for certain is that the machine was the inspiration behind the Vril Levitation Power Unit. At the beginning of 1924, the machine was dismantled and taken to Augsburg in southern Germany for storage, perhaps to the Messerschmitt aircraft factory. As a member of the Thule Society, Rudolf Hess gave a number of lectures and was, among others, one of the people responsible for the early encouragement this new technology was accorded. In all things, we are able to recognize two principles which decide upon matter and events: light and darkness, good and evil, creation and destruction. These two principles, the creative and the destructive, determine our technical means. Another advocate of this new technology was Victor Schauberger. Your propulsion theory is a mistake. This statement was made by inventor Victor Schauberger, who was believed to be associated with these esoteric societies. It addresses one of the essential points of the issue. Nowadays, we would call this the search for an alternative form of energy. Back then, however, there was much more at stake, namely the quest for another science, a radically different technology. To put it simply, we could say implosion instead of explosion. The positive elements among the esoteric scholars of the Third Reich were aware that all divine creations have always been creative, never destructive. a technology which results in explosions and is based on the principle of destruction, cannot therefore really be in keeping with divine intentions. All internal combustion engines, for example, whether piston engines or rocket propulsion systems, work on the principle of an explosion, in other words, with destructive capabilities. Their ultimate effect is sure to be destructive. The environmental damage meanwhile visited on the planet by the technology of explosion, including atomic energy, exhaust fumes, and so on, makes it quite clear that the call for a new technology, like the one under discussion back then, is clearly justified. Victor Schauberger's experimental flying prototypes worked on the principle of levitation. Esoteric knowledge played an ever-increasing role in the search for new sources of energy and motive power. Such research as there was particularly important in the development of electrogravitational and tachometric propulsion. This seemed to be at the very core of the alternative technology. The energy source of the future, cheap, clean, and independent of raw materials. Two special departments, U-13 and SSE-4, were set up to concentrate exclusively on the realization of this new technology.
The intuition Johannes Kepler's führte ihn zu dem Geheimwissen der Pythagorea.
The Johannes Kepler introduced him to the secrets of Pythagoras. Victor Schauberger's vibratory theories tied in with the traditional teachings of Pythagoras and Johannes Kepler. The monochord, an acoustic measuring instrument used by Pythagoras, demonstrates to us how the universe was created using sounds, which we obtain through a division of the science. The entire universe was created using this principle of harmonic resonance.
Nach dem Prinzip der Obertonreihe ist der ganze Kosmos aufgebaut. Ganzzahlige Verhältnisse, Proportionen bestimmen den Aufbau der Materie.
Auch im Weltall
und in den Atomen. Das chemische Periodensystem der Elemente, die Mendelschen Vererbungsgesetze, die Blattstellungsgesetze bei den Pflanzen, auch der Kristalle und so weiter. Überall, wo wir mathematische Strukturen, Proportionen haben, kommen wir auf das Grundprinzip des Monochords,
wherever we have mathematical structures and proportions, we encounter the basic principle of the monochord, harmonic proportions.
Seine integrale Technik und seine Lehre von den inneren Welten, von den Schwingungen der inneren Welten,
in order to develop and build upon his integral skills and his knowledge of the inner universe and its vibrations.
Nicht euklidisch.
One more thing,
die Geheimlehre der Pythagorea wurde von den Templerorden übernommen,
the secret teachings of Pythagoras were taken up by the Templar Order, guarded and passed on. Victor Schauberger made use of this knowledge to develop his theories, and in so doing discovered implosion.
Anhand des Energieplans der Natur sehen Sie hier,
in keeping with the laws of nature, we can see here Alpha and Omega, the keynote to the overturn going on further to the last tone and ending in the creation of the entire universe.
Alpha
symbolically,
und Omega,
Alpha and Omega represent spirit and
Geist
matter. Therefore, what we have here is something
also
whole.
Hier es mit
this
etwas
knowledge therefore makes an all-embracing
tun.
Science possible.
Diese Lehre macht
implosion
auch
is the utilization of the potential
Technik
of the inner universe within the outer
Inklusion
universe.
Ist die Nutzbarmachung des
due to the forces of energy and evolutionary science, we've been able to make great strides in the field of antimatter and with it do away with the effects of gravity.
Gelangen wir in den Bereich der Antimaterie und damit zur Aufhebung der Schwerkraft.